Welcome back, everybody. We are now going to switch the topic a little bit. We are speaking about community outreach and specifically about a village Wallowa, and we're going to find out what that is all about. Joining me this morning is my two guests, one in person, who is Chanel Glasgow, no stranger to the set. Hey, good morning.
Good morning.
And joining me via Zoom is Kirsten Arine. Now, you are both executives of the village Wallowa. It's not really a movement. What is it really?
It's an initiative that we're starting.
So first off, what is Wallowa? I don't understand what it is.
Well, it's actually an indigenous term, and it means stop here or rest here. We wanted to pay tribute to our first people in Trinidad and Tobago, and there are a lot of areas that are still named after them in Trinidad and Tobago, and we really got that vibe from the space that we're having the event.
Right.
So we decided to just pay tribute and have that.
And Carissa, you are here with us as well. Good morning again. Tell us about the choice of the Sangre Grande area for this initiative, and what it's going to be all about.
Well, both Ms. Glasgow and myself, we're both from Sangre Grande. I'm not sure if you would have been aware, but Chanel Glasgow recently represented us in the Miss World Trinidad and Tobago competition. So in looking at the space, we would have shot some stuff at Tantra Terraces. We had this lovely idea to do a cultural market for the community. The space just stood out to us. It's a beautiful space. And we kind of wanted to showcase our community and bring Sangre Grande to the wider Trinidad.
Right. Yeah. And let me jump to you, Chanel. How did this concept and vision originate for this project?
Like Carissa mentioned, we were doing some shots at Tantra, and the moment we stepped foot in that space, the ambience and the atmosphere of it was so calming. And even though it's a space that most people in Grande would know because a lot of events, weddings and stuff are held there, I don't think we've ever seen this space transform in a way where we can have a cultural fair, so to speak. And we really wanted to give people that idea of just hidden in our own town is a little hidden oasis that we can go to and have a nice day. And we want to invite the rest of Trinidad and Tobago to come along with us to experience that. And when we approached the owner of the space, Candice Katwaru, she was so on board. And she's been involved in a number of festivals and events in Trinidad and Tobago, namely Soca Street Festival. And so she was like, yeah, this is something that we could definitely do, because as her line of work, she does it for the rest of Trinidad and Tobago, but she's never done it for her own community and her own hometown. So she thought it was a brilliant and the right timing to do it as well.
And, it seems like you are both so excited about the project.
Very much.
And I'm looking forward to what is to come from it as well. What is the hope for the initiative?
Well, we want to give people from the Far East, we call it the Far East, a platform. Because there are a lot of creative people in Sangre Grande, a lot of people who go out there to the general public and make their names for themselves. And there's so many activities taking place outside in the West or in South, but there's nothing really in the East like that. There's nothing that really comes as far as Grande. And now with the pandemic, we're seeing a lot of people jumping in their cars and heading up to Mayaro for roast fish or lobster or whatever, or to experience the Manzan Coast, the boardwalk, all these new things that opened up in the East. And so this this location is just on the main road, on the way to all of these places. And we really want to give the Sangre Grande people and people of the Far East that platform to really show what their products are, because a lot of young entrepreneurs, young artists, musicians, dancers, you name it. And we will open it up to the general public as well, so that they can take part, but also come and experience it with us.
Wonderful. And Carissa, before we go, if people wanted more information and to reach out, how could they do so?
They could find us on Facebook or Instagram. Look for at Village Wallowa, just as it's spelled on its television. Or they can give us a call at 344-1034.
344-1034. Well, you heard it here first. There's something to do in Sangre Grande, and that would be at the Tantra Terraces, 7F Eastern Main Road in Sangre Grande itself. I want to thank both my guests for joining us this morning. And we look forward to what is to come from this initiative and this project and see many more like it. So I want to thank you so much, Chanel Glasgow. I want to thank you as well, Carissa and Ryan. We're now at the top of the hour, so we're going to close off for the news at the top. and we'll be back with the second half of the show after that. See you watching.